Attitude check. Bronco
Pride. In 1867, 2 years past the Emancipation Proclamation, newly enslaved people who were free were now looking for opportunities to become enriched as well as educated. 7 black men came together and put in $136 and bought 2 plots of land right here in Fayetteville. And upon that vision, they created an institution that started out as a teaching college that has developed into a fully accredited university under the state of North Carolina with 33 undergrad programs, 17 graduate programs, and 1 doctoral degree. This is Fayetteville State. Hello everyone, my name is Amarish Hawkins and I'll be your virtual tour guide.
Broncos, welcome to Fayetteville State University in the great city of Fayetteville. We are so excited to have you with us. Bronco Pride.
Welcome to downtown Fayetteville, scenic Fayetteville, and it's also historic Fayetteville. We have all of the attractions from Antonella's restaurant to art galleries to candle shops and even our own tea shop ran by some of our Fayetteville alum.
My name is William Carr. I'm a 1977 graduate of Fayetteville State University. I graduated with a degree of biology, and with the preparation that Fayetteville State gave me in 1977, I went on to Meharry Medical College and got my DES degree.
The Science and Technology Complex was built in 2012 and houses the Eco Ground Coffee Shop, which is our version of a high-end premier coffee cafe where one can buy smoothies, espressos, frappes, or muffins with their Bronco Bucks that are included with their meal plan. The Center for Defense and Homeland Security Program and Certification is also located here. Our nationally accredited majors such as Forensic Science, Biotechnology, Molecular, Organismal Biology, Plant Sciences, Dental Hygiene, and even Respiratory Therapy is located in this building. We cannot forget all of our pre-medical, our pre-pharmaceutical and dental programs. Our chemistry, entrepreneurship, computer science, and mathematic programs are also located in this complex. In fact, within this complex, it's also home to our 3+2 engineering program, whereas a student can receive 2 degrees in 5 years. 3 years with us and 2 years with NC State, students that are part of the College of Health Science and Technology run the BioReef and other internships associated with NASA and the city of Fayetteville. Did I forget to mention we have a planetarium? Yes, indeed. Speaking about all these sciencey things, I have a joke about chemistry, but I don't think you'll get a reaction. Okay, moving on. The Southeastern North Carolina Nursing Education and Research Center. Whew! The nursing program at Fayetteville State University journeys in achieving nursing excellence, which began in 1992 through a joint partnership program with UNCP. This vibrant program has thrived throughout our history to meet the needs of registered nurses in this region and beyond. We continue to educate a large number of nurse leaders who play a significant role in the health maintenance of citizens in North Carolina and the rest of the country. This is where one will train with simulators that respond like live humans. They cry, they bleed, and they give birth. To further the nurses' training, our students are active in the community. Their clinical experience includes working with our military communities, providing COVID testing, and travel with our nursing RV that doubles as a mobile health clinic.
I chose Fayetteville State because it was close to home. It's local. I started off at Fayetteville Tech, and this was an easier transition for me.
The library was named after an African-American author. He's an essayist, a political activist, and a lawyer, best known for his novels and short stories, and he explores the complex issues of racial and social identity in the post-Civil War South. At the library, one can access full-text articles and information databases, 7 large and medium group study rooms with flat-screen TVs, blackboards, and podiums. There's a laptop checkout program and over 80 computers in the library with Microsoft Office Suite and internet capabilities. We even have a rental program, whereas if we do not have the book that you need, you can get it from another educational institution free of charge. Don't forget about the FSU Bronco One Stop, located in the library, where one can go and connect with their advising center or apply for financial aid and pay any school-related bill to get help and register for their classes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Chestnut Library. The G.L. Butler Building was named after a prominent dentist and chairman of the Board of Trustees here at FSU. This building is home to our School of Education and Performing Arts majors. Students in this building pursue their degrees in birth through kindergarten, elementary education, middle school, and high school education. This building is equipped with a mini theater to produce plays, workshops, and smiles. Hello to all our performing arts majors. The Broadwell College of Business and Economics Building. Our business school is accredited by the Association to Advance Collegiate Schools of Business, the AACSB, which is one of the most prestigious and rigorous accrediting programs. Currently, less than 1/3 of the U.S. business schools and only 5% of the international business schools have earned the AACSB accreditation. We also offer the only SAP certification program in the state. SAP is an acronym for Systems, Applications, and Products. It's a software program used by top companies and by the military to track customer and business interactions. In this building, students take advantage of our majors that include Banking and Finance, Business Administration, Information Systems and Business Analytics, Concentrations in Disaster Management, Healthcare Management, Entrepreneurship Management, and even Fire Emergency Services Administration. This building is equipped with a day trading room where students receive stock prices in real time and access to our convenience store on the first floor, just in case you need to grab a snack before that exam.
Welcome everyone to the Loretta Taylor Building. This building is home to our Air Force ROTC and our Criminal Justice majors. Speaking of Air Force ROTC, one should inquire about their program that will pay for your education in return to allow you to become a commissioned officer. Fun fact, Loretta Taylor was a Hall of Fame coach for our university, and she was a former instructor. In regards to the ROTC, it also applies on the Army side, which we'll visit one of their buildings just in a little bit. This is the Taylor Science Building, or the Taylor Social Science Annex. This building was named in honor of Robert R. Taylor, the first Black graduate of MIT. Taylor was also a member of Booker T. Washington's Tuskegee Cabinet. It's a lot of history here. It is in this building where you will visit certain majors. You can go see our history majors, even our English department. Maybe you want to look into our psychology, criminal justice. All these things are encapsulated within this building and building surrounding. So if you have an interest in them, go ahead and contact them. Also, don't forget about the Army ROTC, which is downstairs, and they will give you information as to how they can pay for your education. The Telecom Building. Formerly known as the Old Library, this is the Creatives Safe Space. As a communications major, it is here where one will receive an opportunity to learn how to be an on-air personality. You'll also learn how to work the media boards and use our state-of-the-art cameras in our state-of-the-art television studio and practice your state-of-the-art photography. Hey, did I mention everything is state-of-the-art? Speaking of photography, welcome to the Rosenthal Building. Home to our illustrious band, in this building, you will hear the sweet chords of harmony as our musicians practice in the soundproof room, following the majestic voices of our university choir, practicing and readying themselves to take a trip across the state to represent our school. Let's not forget our own art studio that students contribute by creating works of art and expression, which is available to the public upon the days that it's open. Let's take a look at our residence halls. Our residence halls are a student's home away from home. Our residence halls are a mix of suite and hall styles. Located near the top of campus, students are a few steps away from the School of Business and Economics building and the Butler building. The residence hall includes spacious rooms with carpet, a full-size bed per resident, and a large 5x4 window per room for a marvelous view of our campus. An example of one of our premier residence halls on Fayetteville State's campus is the Hackley Honors Hall. This hall was established in 1998 and named in honor of Fayetteville State University's former chancellor, Dr. Lord Vic Hackley. It's located in the middle of campus. It's a suite-style co-ed residence hall that is home to the International Education and the Global Scholar communities. Now, these rooms, they include the twin-size beds and mattress, desk, chairs, a closet, and a dresser for your wardrobe. Welcome everyone to the Capo Arena. This is the best gym and or the facilities in the CIAA. Sports complex holds a dance studio, a state-of-the-art weight room, and an Olympic-sized swimming pool with a high diving platform. Recently, our sports teams have been successful and a problem to the rest of the league by adding championships upon championships to our women's basketball, our women's volleyball, track and field, bowling, and cross country. All have won championships. Our men's basketball team is of championship caliber, and our football team has been to the championship game 3 years in a row. Wait a minute, I feel a dad joke coming on. What do sprinters eat before a race? Nothing, they fast. Capo Arena, ladies and gentlemen. The Rudolph Jones Student Center. Named after the sixth president of the university, this building is considered the hub of student life at FSU. Here you will find students enjoying a sandwich from Chick-fil-A, and don't forget the lemonade, please. This is also where you'll come together and celebrate special events at FSU, such as Rodeo Week, the infamous stroll-offs by members of the Greek fraternities and sororities, and let's not forget homecoming. Attitude, church. Come inside the plaza on the top floor as a student. You will have access to our student lounge, the auditorium. This is where you'll have your freshman orientation and, of course, the multi-purpose room. Downstairs on the lower level of the student center, you will have entrance to our game room, having access to multiple gaming systems. What a great place to practice on your Xbox, PlayStation, or any other gaming console. Particularly for our future e-gaming majors. You can also play foosball or shoot some pool. We also have a movie theater that seats 100 students, which allows us to debut your newest shows on your favorite streaming site, or you can just Netflix and chill. The main dining hall, equipped with 7 food stations that has a rotating menu built to fit any and all of your nutritional needs, including chicken fried Wednesdays, fried fish Fridays. Did someone ask for a fresh omelet? No problem. Hamburger and fries? You got it. But my personal favorite is the all-you-can-eat cereal bar. Uh-oh, I feel a dad joke coming on. Hey, what do you call mac and cheese that gets all in your face? Too close for comfort food. Lastly, the Student Center is home to our Student Government Association, Student Activities Council, our Career Services, who are there to help you build your resume and secure the job. Oh, and don't forget our Bronco Spirit Shop, filled with the latest must-have apparel to be a Bronco.
At the Spalding Building, we offer student health services, which provides a variety of confidential clinical health services. They include acute medical care for women and men's health, STI counseling, screening, and treatment, laboratory services, or as they say across the pond, laboratory, family planning, pharmacy services, sports physicals, ROTC physicals, and we also provide COVID-19 testing for students who are symptomatic or have a known exposure or were notified through contact tracing. The Seabrook Auditorium. This auditorium was named after the fifth president of the university. In this venue, students come together to watch shows, have turn-up sessions, concerts, and have an occasional celebrity and or political figure to speak words of encouragement. The Seabrook Auditorium is where you'll attend the freshman pinning ceremony, convocations, and signature events like Founders Day. There is a beautiful fountain out front that glows FSU blue at night, and FSU has a robust performing and fine arts department. Enjoy concerts, art exhibits, and theatrical performances here at the Seabrook Auditorium.
I will win at my life, and in so doing, give others permission to do the same. God bless you, baby.
So you might have made just a B cut and coming in here. Appreciate you, brother.